Welcome to this video. We are talking about water. If you read newspaper or if you watch TV, you would have noticed a lot of news about floods in different places. And then you would have also seen about news on drought in so many other places. Life is possible on earth only because of presence of air and water. We do not know any other planet where living beings exist. So water is very essential for life forms, for plant, for animals, for human beings. You would have read in newspapers that so many states of India are suffering from drought, that is, there is no enough water, not only for cultivation or agriculture. There is no water for wildlife in the forest for them to drink. There is no water for people to wash or bathe. There is no adequate water for drinking or cooking. This is happening because whenever it rains, if it rains, the water just runs off to the sea. It does not get collected in ponds and lakes. And in many places, because there are no ponds and lakes, there is no evaporation happening and no rains are happening. So normally we hear that if you plant a lot of trees, then you will have a lot of rains. And when you have no rains, you will not have any plants or trees or vegetation. So this is happening nowadays. 100 years ago, 500 years ago, there was a lot of rainfall. Let us talk about the desert in India. We have Thar desert in Rajasthan in India. There was a great king called Kadzi. He built 9 lakes in Jaisalmer. And it is not now, it was 700 years ago. So the 9 lakes were so built that whenever one lake is full, the water will overflow into the next lake and then to the next and then to the next. Like this, all the 9 lakes will get filled by the rainwater. So the people of Jaisalmer were able to live without any water shortfall throughout the year. So this was one of the greatest charity work that the king did and one of the greatest scientific activity, where the water from the natural rain were collected and stored by the community for use by all the people throughout the year. Today, nobody is using that lake and there is no water in those lakes because townships, offices, factories, houses, apartments have all come up and nobody is giving any consideration to the lake. But in those days, the lake had guards, the lake had places for people to stay, the lake was the center of so many celebrations. Even today, most of our festivals are held in and around water bodies. We have our celebrations near sources of water. For example, Pushkar Lake is even today famous for the various festivals we have. But the lake that we are talking about in Jaisalmer, the great 9 lakes of Gadsi, are now in disuse because of so-called development, where we have built offices, homes and factories. So there is, even if there is a rainfall, there is not adequate scope for collecting of water into these lakes. What is a heritage? Traveler Al-Biruni of Uzbekistan came to India and 1000 years ago he had written that Indians had a great culture and scientific advancement of building or digging beautiful lakes and ponds for managing water. So from the history, from what other people have written about us, from what people from other countries have observed about us, we know that we had a great heritage of harvesting rainwater, storing rainwater and ensuring water is available throughout the year. But today, we have lots of pavements, we have lots of tiles, we lay a solid opaque surface on the surface of the earth. So the water that comes from the rain that falls on the earth is not getting collected into these water bodies. Water is not soaking or seeping into the soil. Water flows and runs away to the sea with no benefit to anybody. Because of this, so many places are flooded during rains, and then after the rains are over, almost the most of India are suffering drought for most of the year. Today, city of Chennai does not have adequate drinking water. People cannot even buy water. Water has to be brought from other neighboring cities and towns. This is happening because all the water in the reservoir is dried up. There is no enough rainfall for the rivers to bring water into the reservoir. This is happening because the city is so densely populated with houses and roads and buildings that even if the rain falls, the water goes into the sea, does not go into the ground. And because water does not go into the ground, the wells are dried up. Wells don't have water. Water harvesting. What is water harvesting? When the rainwater falls, we should do our best to ensure this rainwater is collected into the pits so that the water goes into the soil and from there it seeps into the wells and ponds. In good old days when there were lots of lakes and ponds, the water there will go in, will get connected during the rain, and then slowly it will be soaked up by the earth, by the ground, and the ground water level will rise. Accordingly, the wells will get replenished. For this, we need open land. We need land and soil that can suck up the water. If you have all tiles, if you have all cement, the water will run away to the sea. People in deserts of Rajasthan know better about rainwater harvesting than the people today in the cities. Why? Because water is scarce in deserts. People have, by their experience, by their past, they have learned their lessons and they have learned how to ensure water is properly harvested. They used to have big pots to collect the rainwater. They used to have different types of lakes. They are called johards and bavdis. What is a bavdi? Bavdi is a step well. You go into the well is so big as a pond or a lake, first thing. Second thing, you go into the lake or the pond or the well by climbing steps. Step by step by step, you go deep into the well. And then you can carry the water and come out. You don't need to carry the water up by using a rope and a pulley. You can walk down the steps and get water. And these were built in so many places. Every here and there, a lot of step wells were built in good old days, so that when people were going in caravan from place to place, they could find adequate water because it was desert. So people of Rajasthan, people of the desert knew that it is important to collect the rainwater. They knew the importance of well. They knew the importance of collecting the water and putting it into the pits, into the earth, into the ground, so that water grows into the ground. So lakes, johars, bavdis, step wells were dug or built by the people in those days. Most of our festivals are around these step wells. Digging ponds is a very great philanthropic activity, very big charitable activity, because without water, no life form can exist. But today, reservoirs and rivers and wells are drying up because water is not collected into the soil, not allowed to go into the soil. Why it dries up? It dries up because the soil is not ready to receive the soil, the water, the mud, the ground, the field is not ready to receive the water. There is no enough scope for the water to be seeped into the ground. The tanks need to be desilted and cleaned. Wells dry up because of overuse of water and no replenishment. Replenishment will happen only if the water remains in the surface of the earth and then goes down. If it runs to the sea, if the water runs away, then there will be no replenishment of well water. And because of this, people are finding it difficult to get water from the well. So we have to get water from elsewhere. Suppose we are trying to get it from the reservoir. That will come only if the river is having water. So the dams are also not having enough water because the rains are less and whatever is remaining is getting flooded and running away instead of getting collected in the reservoirs. In cities, we used to have piped water. The water used to come through pipes and the pipes used to bring water from the overhead water tank. The overhead water tank used to get water from the reservoir pumped from the dams. But even that is drying out nowadays because of the overall lesser availability of water. Some places the water used to come 24 hours. Now it is coming only for 1 or 2 hours in a day. Some places water is coming only once in a week. In some places water is brought by tankers. So tanker does not come daily. Tanker comes once in a while. And all the people have to queue up and then collect the water, and the water is rationed out. So the various governments try, the local bodies try to bring water to the people. But it is not easy. Even if you are willing to pay, even if you are willing to bring water from elsewhere, there should be water available. If water is not there, however amount you pay, you cannot get water. Water is a natural resource. It's a God-given gift. Still, if you want to pay also, if there is no water available, how can you get it? And without water to drink, without water to cook, without water to wash, no human being can exist. And animals and plants will also perish if there is no water. So if animals and plants don't exist, we cannot have our food even. So water is very essential. Water will cause war. People will fight with each other for the sake of water because water is an essential commodity. But the important fact is, water is a natural resource. It's a God-given gift. It belongs to everybody. It belongs to the whole community. It belongs to the whole society. Some people have to buy water, but some people cannot afford to buy water. And some people, even if they can afford, they cannot buy because water is not available. In deserts, people have to walk miles to get one pitcher of water with which they will cook and drink and do everything. In Middle Eastern countries, because they are deserts, a very expensive desalination plant have been set up to prepare water to make it fit for drinking or cooking by reverse osmosis. It is very costly exercise, but that has been tried, but that cannot be done very well. So it is important for us to ensure water is not wasted. It is important for us to ensure whatever rainwater is there that is properly harvested. It is important to ensure we allow the water to go into the ground to fill the lakes and the ponds so that the wells will get replenished. And it is important to ensure water is not overused. Water is a very precious commodity. Thanks for watching this video on EVS Water.